Hello, in this patch I show you how to make a simple sample-based synthesis, in particular how to recreate a simul DJ scrub effect with your sample sounds. Before we start, let's prepare our project. This will be the audio file that I will use for this patch. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can use any audio file of any length, sample rate, or bit depth. The important thing is that it is an uncompressed file, such as .wav or AF. To simplify things, let's save this audio file inside the same folder where we are going to save our patch. In this way, it will be possible to recall the audio file within the patch by specifying only its name and its extension, as we will see shortly. Perfect. Now we can close the folder and start creating our algorithm. First, we will have to load the audio into a memory buffer. To do this, we will add the array. It is important to define a unique name for the array. We will set the size automatically, so the array will adapt based on the length of the audio file you upload. To do this, we create a message with these commands. Read, which reads the audio file. Dash resize, which will display the number of samples in the audio file and adjust the length of the array accordingly. The name of the audio file with its extension. The name of the array. This data will be sent to the array thanks to the SoundFiler object, whose the left output will return the number of samples present in the loaded audio file. Finally, to anticipate what the final user interface will be, let's add a bang to launch the message that will load the audio file. Before proceeding with audio playback, we need to create an interactive interface to drive the sound contained in the array. Let's then create a slider to replicate the scrub effect given by DJ turntablism on vinyl records. Within the properties of the slider interface, we will have to modify the maximum value. This must correspond to the maximum value of the number of samples of the loaded audio file. To make this procedure automatic, we connect the left output of the SoundFiler object to a message with range, which we'll call the relevant property of the slider interface, the minimum value of 0 as the array starts from index 0, the variable maximum value, which will be set every time we load a new audio file. Now let's proceed with playing the audio. The slider will take care of reading the individual samples contained within the array. These values can change very abruptly, generating very marked glitches typical in digital audio. To make the sound more similar to analog devices, we will apply linear envelopes when changing these values via the line tilde object, which will smooth the movements by 100 milliseconds. These values will be sent to the tabred 4 tilde object with the name of the array we want to read and then play. We will apply a high-pass filter with a cutoff frequency around 5 Hz to avoid possible DC offsets due to very low reproduction frequencies. Finally, to the audio output. As you will hear shortly, the movement speed that we apply by moving the slider interface will directly influence the pitch of the audio playback. 1, 2, 3, 4. To conclude, let's create a graphical interface like the one I presented to you at the beginning of this video. To do this, we will need to create a subpatch and copy the entire algorithm into it, except the output tilde object. Inside the subpatch, we create an outward link with the outlet tilde object to subsequently send the audio to the output tilde object. We then right-click in an empty spot in the canva within the subpatch. In the properties, we tick the graph on parent. This will show us a red rectangle where we can insert all the user interfaces we want to show in the main patch. Let's modify the size of this rectangle so that we can better insert the array graphic object and the bang to load the audio file. If we want to move the rectangle to another point in the subpatch Canva, we modify the margin values. The array covers the entire rectangle. In my case, I will make the interface of the array itself smaller. I move the bang label accordingly to make everything more readable. I change the slider display to cover the size of the array interface. If we go back to the main patch, we will notice that the array writing overlaps with the subpatch name. We can remove the subpatch name by ticking within the subpatch properties Hide Object Name and Arguments. Now, another problem arises. If we try to move the slider from the main patch, we will notice that we will instead modify the contents of the array. To fix it, we will have to send a message to the array disabling the related modification property. We will apply it via a load bang every time the patch is opened. Let's save the patch, close it and reopen it to see if everything works properly. Thanks for your attention. Happy patching.